Here I like to show where I do my model ship work. It's basically in a garage with a table that I built some time ago, but it has two cars in the garage, and my old 300ZX is actually the carrier for the plants on the hood. On the other side of the garage is this old shopsmith that I've used for many years. And also here is where I have a table with a jigsaw, a disc sander, and a small bandsaw. There's also a table saw with a sliding miter table, very handy, and a small mini lathe. This one, I have a whole bunch of different fixtures for it that are stored right above it, including a large selection of drill bits. I have drill bits that go anywhere from about half inch or even bigger than that, down to the number 80, which is the tiny ones. But the ones I really like have the thicker, the 1/8 inch shank. Another feature, just right where the drill press is this turnstile. It's a carousel, actually, that has six sides with panels that rotate, and I can store all sorts of tools, and as you can see, I have a lot more room to fill that in if I want to. But in addition to that, there are panels on the inside to hold drills, I mean taps and dies, and it is very useful to me. Besides drilling, I use my drill press for a variety of other things, such as this drum sander. And here I use about a 2.5 inch diameter drum. But you've noticed on the table there are two additional holes, and they are basically for other diameter drums. And here, for example, is one that belongs with the Dremel tool. It's simply a matter of rotating the table and lining it up so that there's clearance for the sander. The Dremel type tool is quite old. I bought it at Monkey Ward, Montgomery Ward, many years ago. But it, all of the various fixtures fit in this drawer, which makes it easy to store and move around if I have to. This Dremel tool, I'll call it, it comes in handy also on the drill press. I made a special fixture so that I can mount it on the quill and use the drill press actually to do the drilling that way. It is great for very tiny holes and repetitive operations. Another thing I can do with my drill press is to use it as a thickness sander. I made this special feature where there's a drum and some slides, and it worked very well. The end of the fence has some adjustments, so I can make adjustments for the thickness of this sanding. Very good. The bandsaw, the sander, and the jigsaw, as you notice, have a wooden plate on top of the table. This is basically a zero clearance insert to prevent small pieces from slipping down where the blade goes. The bandsaw, for example, has a very close fit where the blade goes through this plate, so that I can make very fine little cuts on the bandsaw as well as on the jigsaw. The jigsaw in particular, when you cut small pieces on this, there is virtually no tear out on the back side because of this zero clearance plate that I added here. As I remove this little piece and turn it over, you can see that on the back side there's virtually no tear out, and the front and the back look just about the same. I made a modification to my shopsmith so that I could actually use it as a very small table saw. It has a 4-inch blade and a very crude but very effective little fence so that I can rip blades or pieces to very good tolerances, actually. It takes a little bit of practice to set it up and fine-tune it. And for this demonstration, I didn't go into too much detail. But even at that, I am able to hold tolerances of the width, for example, to within a couple thousandths. One of my most favorite measuring tools, besides a few rulers, is this dial indicator of vernier calipers. I use it for measuring thicknesses and so on, of course. And a variety of little files, as well as the larger ones that I've used over the years for various woodworking projects. And all woodworkers have never enough clamps. These are just a small variety that I have mounted here. But on the workbench, I have a little box with a bunch that I use for modeling chips. Quite a variety.